It's a battle of the Knights on homecoming week for your Creekside Knights as they get ready to take on Oakleaf right here at the castle. And we have got a homecoming episode for you that lives up to the hype, as later on we'll be joined by Darious Williams and Shaq Quarterman from the Jacksonville Jaguars, who are representing each side of this matchup on the Jags. And we'll also break down this battle tonight and see who will claim the title as the superior Knights this year. We've got a great episode ahead. You won't want to miss a moment this morning on Creekside Gameday. Creekside Gameday is sponsored in part by Angela Tharp, real estate advisor and broker associate, 25 years working with buyers and sellers. Reach out to Angela Tharp for your real estate needs. That one painter First Coast, that painter you need, we're the one. And Tom Moore Realtor, Tom covers all of the Jacksonville and St. John's areas. When you need a realtor, ask for Moore. Tom Moore. Hello, everyone, and welcome into Creekside Gameday. I'm your host, Noah Schlicksep. As I mentioned earlier, we have got a great episode ahead for you today, and I won't keep you waiting. Let's dive into this matchup breakdown. Creekside and Oakleaf was a thriller last season. 97 points going up between the two teams, with the Knights coming away with a 49-48 victory with less than 10 seconds to go when they scored their game-winning touchdown. The year before that, the Knights won right back here at Creekside, 37-32, and the four games prior to that, Oakleaf won all of them, scoring no less than 38 points in any of those games. This game has been a shootout every time this series has matched up, and this year, could it be different? Creekside is coming off one of the most exciting victories the Castle has seen, with a 23-22 come-from-behind win over Mandarin last week, with the Knights scoring the game-winning touchdown with under 30 seconds to go on a 4th-and-3. The offense did their job executing their game plan against a stellar Mandarin defense and making plays when it mattered most. But it was the defense that had their best performance in a long time against a Mustang team that came into this one putting up 41 per game with a star-studded passing game. This is a Creekside defense that succeeds as a unit week in and week out. It was a complete team effort to stop that Mandarin offense last week. However, there are a few guys who've been having really good seasons that I wanted to highlight who should be big tonight. First up, Cole Long. He's had a strip sack in back-to-back weeks for the Creekside Knights and has totaled 4 sacks and 7 tackles for loss this year. Alongside him, Tyce Donnelly has been fantastic. He's got 4 sacks. He's also got 4 tackles for loss and has blocked a punt this year. These two have been game wreckers up front. Colton Lavelle has also been a stud at linebacker, racking up 60 tackles in 5 weeks. He had 12 tackles against Mandarin and is having himself a really nice season. And as a unit, the secondary has made massive strides over the past couple weeks for Creekside. Though they played well all around last week, their biggest success was locking down Jamie French, a top 5 receiver in America, holding him to just 2 receptions and 31 yards. This is a unit that's going to need to play really good this week to knock off Oakleaf. As for the other Knights, they're off to a nice start this year, going 2-1 through their first 3 games under new head coach Chris Foy. And after returning just 2 starters from last year, they're led by senior quarterback Brandon Wallace Jr. in his first year as a starter. He's passed for 7 touchdowns to just 2 interceptions in 3 games. Foy described Wallace as he is Oakleaf. He loves this community, loves his school, and he said they'll go as far as Wallace takes them this year. Defensively, they're looking to bounce back after giving up 44 to a powerful Bulls offense last week. They had allowed just 14 points through their first 2 games previous to that, but they'll face another challenge in the Creekside Knights tonight here at the Castle. For each of these teams, this game will have major playoff implications. Creekside knows they need this district win at home after losing to Buholtz in their first district game this year, or this playoff race gets complicated for the Knights. And Oakleaf, they know that their playoff hopes run through Creekside. Getting a win on the road here at the Castle will significantly boost their playoff odds. No matter what, this is a game we'll probably look back on at the end of the season and say this had a major impact on the playoff race. Now moving on to our story of the week, which may be our biggest of the year. What's something these two teams have in common other than their mascot? They each have a former player currently on the Jacksonville Jaguars. Darious Williams, a Creekside graduate in 2011, went from a zero-star recruit to a Super Bowl champion, now starting at corner for the Jags. And linebacker Shaq Quarterman, four-star recruit out of Oakleaf, went to Miami, now at the Jaguars. These two guys took very different paths to the pros, but now they're teammates on their hometown NFL team. They've had this game circled on their calendars for a while. Could you describe the significance of two area teams facing off, same district, and they each have representation in the NFL?
Yeah, I mean, you know, Shaq, we love to talk about it all the time. You know, he just asked me who we got this week. But it's real cool just to see our city blow up, you know, just produce athletes. So it's always cool to see city boys, you know, turn up for their team and always talk about the high school rivalries.
Darious Williams and Shaq Quarterman have emerged as two of the faces of the Jacksonville football community. The Creekside and Oakleaf products are just two of many local football players to make it to the NFL. However, very few can say they've played for their hometown Jaguars. But Darious and Shaq know there's more to come.
We're definitely trying to build a pipeline. You know, you hear all the time about the South Florida high school circuit and all the great talent that's come through there. And we're up here doing our thing as well. And we've had countless, even before me and Darious, you know, we've had countless North Florida stars come out. But, you know, just the fact that it's Creekside and Oakleaf so in so close proximity is great, man. I love to see it, you know. Trash talking for me and him is always a good thing in the locker room, you know, Oakleaf over everything, Old Block over everything, but it speaks volumes to just what the community holds and what the city holds.
For you, representing your city on a week-in, week-out basis for the Jacksonville Jaguars, what does that mean to you to represent the place where you grew up and your local school, Creekside?
I mean, it means everything. You know, that's why I came back home in the first place. But, you know, it's always cool to represent, like you said, just represent the city, represent where I came from, the high school. So it's always fun just being back at home and, you know, getting the recognition that you grew up here and now you're playing for the home team.
Man, it's just an honor, you know, that you never want to take for granted. So every time I get to go out to a game or I get to even talk to, you know, the coaching staff there at my high school, my alma mater now, it's amazing, man, getting to be on the practice field sometimes and just, you know, relive it and see it through my eyes as if I was back in 9th and 10th grade, you know, getting to go to the dungeon where I played so many games and made so many plays with some of my best friends and played against great talent. You know, it's really just a stepping stone to where I am now. And the people of the community are so receptive to me, you know, that sometimes you forget because you're off, you know, or I'm off doing things and competing at this level. But when I get to go home and go back to where I'm from, it's great.
And back at home, Darious and Shaq are remembered for more than just what they've done on the football field, but the work they put in to do so.
Well, you know, you got to understand, me and Shaq, we got a little history now.
Oh, really?
Oh, yeah, we got a little history. And I was, unfortunately, on the other side of that situation. See, I was at Fletcher before I went to Andrew Jackson. I was on the other side of it. But it's kind of bittersweet for me. So I know what kind of player he was. And I will tell anybody now, you know, Shaq Quarterman is the best high school defensive player I've ever seen. He had such a tremendous work ethic and he was such a tremendous leader. So it's not only that he made it, you know, he worked for it. And so he's truly an example of how to do it.
And for Darious specifically, coming here out of Creekside, what does he mean to this local community and this Creekside football program?
Yeah, I've talked about him several times and just kind of his path. to the NFL. It was one that was very different. And if you don't know it, I would urge you to look it up. But you're talking about a guy who had some trials and tribulations and never gave up on his dream and just continued to develop, continued to grow, continued to get better. We're a work-to-win team. And there's no doubt that Darious Williams went through a lot of work to get where he's at and do the things that he is doing currently.
Being on some of those first Creekside teams, you helped lay the foundation for Creekside football. How far have you seen this program come since your time there?
Yeah, they're good, man. You know, the thing about it is, like you said, we kind of laid the foundation, so we always were young. You know, my quarterback my senior year was a sophomore, and now you see kids obviously being senior quarterbacks growing with their team. And, you know, Creekside, you know, the last 2 years, you know, I met with the coach last year. I was at a game, and, you know, he's taking this team a long way.
You've been really involved with this Oakleaf football program as of late. You've been in contact a lot with Chris Foy, I'm sure, their new head coach. Tell me a little bit about the job and what he's building over there at Oakleaf.
Well, I think one thing I know is that he's a great coach. You know, I got the chance to play against him when he was coaching at Fletcher, the time we had to play him twice just to make it further in the playoffs. And then getting the chance to see him in his first offseason with Oakleaf and just the type of program that he's running. And the first thing he says is that, you know, we cannot duplicate who y'all were, but what we will do is have the same focus that y'all had when y'all did accomplish those things. And I see it, you know, it's not just lip service with him. It's a lot of him being interactive with his players. And I think that's very important, not just for the game, but as far as building men.
And you mentioned there, you talked with Shaq a little about this. You think we could get a gentleman's bet going, get one of you to take a picture in the other team's gear for that Creekside Oakleaf game?
Oh, man, you got to ask him. I'm down for it, though. I'm down for it. I'm for sure down for it. So you got to talk to him.
I'm definitely down for that. I got the perfect size for him, man. I may make him put on the whole uniform.
All right, we got to make this happen.
Come on. Come on, we're going to take it to him, man. I'm going to have to tell him that I can't put on no Creekside uniform, so we got to pull this one out for sure.
A huge thank you to the Jaguars PR department as well as Darious and Shaq for helping make this happen. And now moving on to my matchup prediction. Who do I think will be putting on the other team's gear, Darious or Shaq? This is going to be a great matchup between two competitive teams who are looking to make a dent in the district playoff race. And personally, I think it's going to be Shaq putting on some Creekside gear after the Knights come away with a 38-31 win in front of their home fans on homecoming. It is going to be a great game. You don't want to miss it. If you can't make it out, you can listen in right here on Schlick Sports. But for now, I'm Noah Schlicksup signing off saying see you tonight, and I'll see you next time here on Creekside Gameday.